students, today we will discuss about the problems of multiple blocks. First of all, we will take the two block systems. How the two block system? So suppose that we take an example, suppose that there are two blocks, this block, there are two blocks, this block B, this block A is having 10 kg mass, this block B is having 10 kg mass. Now we applied a force F is equal to 50 Newton on block A. Suppose that the coefficient of friction between these two blocks mu is equal to 0.5, and here this surface is smooth. Smooth means that the coefficient of friction is 0. Now the block will move together or move separately, we have to discuss the problem. Now if we draw the FVD of 10 kg block, then 10 kg block is this, this 10 kg block. Block A, here the force 50 Newton works in this direction. Normal mg will work in this direction. Normal will work in this direction, and the friction force works in this direction. Similarly, if we take the 10 kg block block B, if we take block B, the 10 kg block, only force which will act in horizontal direction is F. This Fs. Now if the both block moves together, if the both blocks moves together, then the net force, then the acceleration of the both block will be F is equal to ma. Now F is 10 Newton, the mass of both block is 10 plus 10 is equal to A, the force is 50 Newton. Sorry, the force is 50 Newton. And acceleration will be A is equal to 50 upon 20, that will be equal to 2.5 meter per second square. Now if the this acceleration is, if this the block, both blocks are moving with this acceleration, and what will be the value of static friction working on 10 kg block? So 10 kg block, the value of static friction Fs equal to M into A, that is equal to 10 into 2.5 is equal to 25 meter. So 25 Newton, if we calculate the maximum value of static friction between these two blocks, then Fs max is the limit, maximum value of limiting friction, that is equal to mu into n. So mu is 0.5 into n is 10, that is equal to mu into mg. So mu is m is 10 into 10, that will be equal to 50 Newton. So 50 Newton is the maximum value of static friction, and this is the self-adjustable static friction is 25 Newton, so it is less than 50 Newton. So both blocks will move together with acceleration 2.5 meter per second square. Now, if we increase the force 50 Newton onwards, like if we suppose that we take the example that the force of that is 101 Newton. So will the block move together or will they move separately? Let us discuss here. So if the maximum value of static friction will be remain same, that is equal to 15 Newton. Now if we calculate if the both block moves together, then net force that moves together, the net force is equal to ma. So by net force is equal to ma. So we can say that F is equal to 101 Newton, both block masses of both block is 10 plus 10 into A, so A is equal to 101 upon 20, that is equal to 5.05 meter per second square. Now at this acceleration, what will the value of static friction between these two blocks? It will be equal to F, suppose that this is F, so F is equal to M, that is M into A, M into A, so M is 10 kg and A is 5.05, so it is equal to 15.5 Newton. So which is greater than 50 Newton maximum value of static friction, so if the both blocks will move separately. So if we have to calculate, if we have decided that both blocks move separately, then we have to calculate the acceleration of each block. So how can we calculate the acceleration of each block? Now the both blocks are moving, so the friction working in between these two blocks will be kinetic friction. So if we draw the free body diagram of A, then here the kinetic friction will work. So the kinetic friction will be equal to mu into n. So So it is equal to mu is 0.5. Again m is 10 into g, 10 is equal to 50 newton. Now this Fk here, the friction, static friction will also become the kinetic friction. It is equal to 50 newton. Now we have to calculate the acceleration of each block. Now suppose that the acceleration of mass block A is A. So net force equal to ma. So net force will be 50. That is equal to, sorry, this force, it has become 101 newton. So this has become 101 newton. So net force is equal to 101 minus 50. That is equal to mass into acceleration of A. So it is equal to 51 into 10 into AA. So acceleration of mass block A is 51 by 10 is equal to 5.1 meter per second square. Now similarly, the block of the acceleration of block B is net force equal to ma. So here the kinetic friction is 50 newton, net force is 50, is equal to mass of block B is 10, that is equal to ab. So it is ab is equal to 50 by 10 is equal to 5 meter per second square. That is acceleration of B. So here the acceleration of A is greater than acceleration of B. Now take another example. Suppose that there are two blocks. One block is here, another block is here. Now the block of this block having mass is 10 kg, this block is having mass 20 kg. Now a force of F is equal to 60 newton is applied on 10 kg block, and the coefficient of friction between 10 kg and 20 kg block is mu is equal to 0.5. Now this is smooth, so the coefficient of friction will be 0. Now we have to analyze, will the block move together or move separately. Again we will draw the FVD. FVD is a free body diagram of mass 10 kg. So this is 10 kg, the force is 60 newton. Now the relative, the frictional force will oppose the relative motion. So this is friction force. Now again, if you talk about the mass weight, then 10 g will work in downward direction, normal will work in upward direction. So again here 20 kg block, so 20 kg block is here. Now this friction will act in this direction, and this because this is smooth, so no friction is acting in this direction between the block, this block and the ground, so we will not draw the normal. So here if we calculate the FS max, if we have to calculate between the 10 kg block and 20 kg block, then this is equal to mu into n. It is equal to 0.5 into 10 into g. G is 10, so this is equal to 50 newton. So 50 newton is the maximum value of limiting friction between these blocks. Now if we calculate if both blocks move together, then we calculate the acceleration. So both blocks move together. So if the both blocks move together, then what is the value of the acceleration? So net force is net force equal to ma. So we apply net force equal to ma. Net force is 60 newton. Mass is 10 plus 20. That is into a. So a is equal to 60 upon 30 is equal to 2 meter per second square. Now at this acceleration, what will be the value of static friction between 10 kg and 20 kg? So it will be equal to friction is net force working on 10 kg is m. That maximum, that is static friction is ma. So m is 20 and acceleration is 2. That is equal to 40 newton. So 40 newton is the acceleration, and the maximum value of static friction is limiting friction, that is 50 newton. So it is less than 50 newton. So both blocks will move together. It moves together. Both blocks will move together and having acceleration equal to 2 meter per second square. Now let's take another three blocks problem. Now here the three blocks are given of masses 7 kg, 3 kg and 2 kg. The coefficient of friction is given here. V1 equals 0.2, V2 equals 0.3, V3 equals 0, means this surface is smooth. Now we have to analyze, the acceleration A1, A2, A3. Suppose the acceleration of A1, 2 kg block is A1, 3 kg block is A2, 7 kg block is A3. Now we have applied the 10 newton horizontal force on first on 2 kg block, then on 3 kg block, then on 7 kg block. Then we have to find out the acceleration of each block. Now suppose that we apply the force 10 newton on in this direction on 2 kg block, then what will happen? Now if we draw the FVD of L2 kg block, then the 10 Newton is applied here. The weight G downward will work downward, normal force will work upward. Now the friction between these two is in this direction, that is mu 1 into N is equal to mu 1 is 0.2, N is 2G, 2 means 2 into 10, that is equal to 4 Newton. So 4 Newton is friction and 10 Newton is applied force, so net force will be MA. So net force is 10 minus 4 is net force, is mass into acceleration, mass is 2 kg into acceleration is A1. So it is A1 is equal to 6 by 2, that is equal to A1 is equal to 3 meter per second square. Now A1 is the acceleration of 2 kg block. So what happens to the 3 kg and 7 kg block? So if we draw the FVD of 3 kg, 3 kg is this, this is 3 kg. Now if this friction is working in this direction, then here the friction will work in this direction, that is equal to 4 Newton. Now the friction between 3 kg and 7 kg is, the proportion of friction is 0.3. So 0.3 is in this direction, that is mu 2 into M. M will be the total mass, 3 kg plus 2 kg, that is equal to M1 plus M2 into G. It is the friction. So here, now this value is 0.3 into masses, sum of the masses is 2 plus 3 into 10, that is equal to 3 plus 2, 550, equal to, that is 3 plus 550, 5 is 15, that is equal to 15 Newton. So 15 Newton working in this direction, 4 Newton is working in this direction. So 3 kg block will not leave 7 kg block because the 4 Newton is less than 15 Newton. So the 3 kg block and 7 kg block will move together and the force will be, that external force will be 4 Newton. So net force is 4 Newton, the total masses is 3 plus 7 into A, that is A acceleration. So it will be equal to 4 upon 7 plus 3 is 10. So it will be equal to 2 by 5 is equal to 2 by 5, stop. So the 4 by 10 Newton, that is 4 by 10, that is equal to 2 by 5, it is equal to 0.4 meter per second square. Then that is acceleration A2, this is equal to A3. So both blocks will move together with this acceleration 0.4 meter per second square. Now if we apply, suppose that we change the force from 2 kg to 3 kg. Now on 3 kg, if we apply 10 kg, 10 meter, 10 meter force, then what will happen? So if we apply 10 Newton force on 3 kg, then again we will draw the free body diagram of 3 kg block. So the 3 kg block, if we draw the free body diagram of 3 kg block, then it is equal to 3 kg. Then the 10 Newton force is working in this direction. The force, the friction force between 2 kg and 3 kg will work in this direction, that is mu 1 into N. That is mu 1 is 0.2 into N is 2 into 10, that is equal to 4 Newton. And here the friction force between 3 kg and 7 kg will be mu 2 into N, that is equal to mu 3, 0.3 into 3 plus 2, that is equal to 5 into G 10, that is equal to 15 Newton. So 15 plus 4, that is 19 Newton, which is greater than 10 Newton. So 3 kg block will not move related, will not, 3 kg block will not move relatively to 2 kg and 7 kg. The 3 blocks will move together, 2 kg, 3 kg and 7 kg will move together. So they will move together. So what is acceleration? Acceleration will be the net force will be MA. So net force is equal to 10 Newton. So 10 Newton is equal to net force is equal to MA. MA is M1 plus M2 plus M3 into A acceleration, A2, that is equal to 10 Newton. So 2 plus 3 plus 7 into A2 is equal to 10 Newton. So A2 is equal to 10 upon 7 plus 3, 10, so 12, that is 12. So it will be equal to 5 by 6 meter per second square. That will be the acceleration of this is acceleration of 3 blocks. So A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3, that is equal to 5 by 6 meter per second square. Now, if we calculate, now suppose that in the same way, if you apply the force on 7 kg block, if you apply the force 10 newton on 7 kg block, then what happens? Now, if again we draw the free body diagram of 7 kg here, 10 newton force is applied here. Now this is frictional. This is mu is equal to 0, this is smooth. So the friction will work because of 2 kg and 3 kg in this direction. So it will be equal to, that is mu 2 into m1 plus m2 into g. So this is mu 2 is equal to 0.3. Masses of sum of the masses is 50, that is 3 plus 2, 5, 5 into 10 is 50, is equal to 15 newton. So 15 newton is the force, this is working in this direction, and 10 newton force is working in this direction. So the block will, the 2 kg, 3 kg block will stay on the 7 kg. They have same acceleration, and the acceleration will be, again, we have to apply the net force to MA. So acceleration would be M1 plus M2 plus M3 into 4, that is force is 10 newton. So acceleration would be M1 is, again sum of the masses is 7, so that is sum of M1 is 2 kg plus 3 plus 7 into is equal to 10. So this is into. So acceleration would be 10 upon 12, that is equal to 5 by 6 meter per second square. So both three blocks will move together with the acceleration 5 by 6 meter per second square.